Hello guys, this is Deepika from MyTutorialRack.com. Now in the previous tutorial, we did an example where we tried to retrieve the different types of records, account records, student records, school records with their ID. Now in this tutorial, we are going to see how to insert new records into Salesforce. So first thing is I wanted to give you a difference between these two methods, get and post. So a get method is used to retrieve something from the server. It is not going to make any changes on the server, whereas the post method is used to create a new record or to post something on the server. Now in the case of REST, you can send data in an XML format, or you can also send data in a JSON format. You can do both ways, but in the case of the SOAP, you can only send data in a XML format. So now in this tutorial, what we're going to do is we're going to see how to create new student records or new school records or new account records from Postman and via the REST APIs. So the first thing is I'm going to change the method from get here to post, because this is something I'm doing is I'm creating a new record, and I'm going to say that what kind of record I'm going to create. Let's say I want to create a new account record. So the first thing that I will be doing is I will use this URL, and the URL will be objects_C. Let's just go ahead and copy this whole thing and paste it over here. And I'm trying to create a new account record to replace it with the account. And I'm doing a post request, and in the header, I will be passing in the authorization header here, and the value would be bearer, and then the whatever I retrieved. So let me just do a send here, get the latest access token. So let's just go ahead and copy this, and then I'm going to paste it over here, and you have to give a space in between them, and then the body. So I can send the data in an XML format, or I can do it in the JSON. So for timing, we are going to send it in an XML format, and we'll also see how to send it in the JSON format. So in here, we are going to say we are trying to create a new account record. So I'm going to pass in the account, and then I'm going to say close this tag here. Now, what is the required field on the account? So the required field on the account is name. So let me go back here, and let's pull up go to the edit object and go to some of the fields that are available under the account object. So the first is the name. So let me say the name of the account that I'm going to create is going to be called as MyTutorialRack. Okay, this is going to be the name of the account. Now, if I wanted to add, let's say I also wanted to add the site. Okay, so here I'm going to say the site, it's a text field. So I'm just going to say MyTutorialRack.com. And then this is going to be the site. Then the next field, whatever field you wanted to send, you can send it. If you wanted to go ahead and send the annual revenue, billing address, all this information. Let's say we wanted to send phone number. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy the phone number here, go to my body of the message, and I'm going to paste in the phone number. And then I'm going to say phone. Close this. So this is the three fields, the information that I'm going to pass, and I'm going to create a new account record. Okay, so let's go ahead and hit the send here. In the header, I've already set up the authorization. This is the body. This is an XML format right now. So let's go ahead and hit the send. And you can see here, it returned me back the ID, and the status is 201. So means it got created. The request has been fulfilled and resulted in a new resource being created. So in the 200, that returned us status was okay, means whatever you did, whatever you asked, we have returned you. But in the 201, something new got created on the server. So that is the status code when a new thing gets created. And this is the ID of that record that got created. Now, if I go back here to my account records, if I go ahead and click here and look for accounts, you will see that a new account record with the name MyTutorialRack has been added. So let's just go ahead and test. You can see here MyTutorialRack has been added. We entered the, let's look at the details. the phone number we provided is there. And then the next thing is the account site is also there. This piece of information has been added. Now, this data was in a form of XML. Now, if you wanted to send it in a form of JSON, you can do that as well. All you have to do is you just go ahead and convert this data into JSON. And how do we do that? If you don't know, don't worry about it. There are a lot of online applications available that can do it for you. So you can say XML to JSON converter. And here I'm going to select the first one that I see, and I'm going to paste this here. And then I'm going to say convert the XML to JSON. And this is the response that I got. So all I'm going to do here is I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it over here. Here, I'm going to paste it. And now here, I'm going to say my tutorial rack. Rather than that, I'm going to say Deepika is the name of the account. And the site name, we remain it as it is. And this is the phone number. And this is going to be in a JSON, same request. It's a post request. And then we're going to go ahead and hit the send. You can see here, it gave us a 201 created, and then it returned us the ID of the newly created record, correct? So now if I go back and if I go here to the account, you will see that a new account record has been added. So you can see if I go back to the accounts tab, and if I refresh it, you will see the Deepika Khanna account has been added, and these are the details. So this is how you create a new record in Salesforce, and we did it using Postman, and we did it by the REST client. So let's go ahead and save this information, and we will say REST create new record. We did it, the account record, we'll save it into this collection, and then hit the save button.